So good afternoon. Again, we are meeting again to finish up the topic of PNF. So properly septal neuromuscular presentation. And in that, we have so far seen four methods. Today, we are going to see the two important methods again. And one of them, the name, as you can already read from the presentation, is contract and relax. Yes? As the name suggests, you have to contract the muscle and then relax the muscle. Yes. So from that itself, you can understand you will contract the muscle and then relax the muscle specifically when you want to improve or increase range of motion. Yes, whenever there is restricted range of motion, can range of motion of two muscles at that time you want to increase the range of motion. Say for example, biceps is restricting elbow extension. Yes, always. આ વસ્તુ યાદ જ રાખવાની છે. Whenever antagonist will restrict the motion. If you treat directly antagonist, it is termed as direct method. Example, biceps flex નથી થવા દેતું હાથમાં. Yes? Or extend નથી થવા દેતું. Yes? So biceps is restricting which range of motion? Flexion. Or extension, it will be extension. Yes, so kai movement hai, motion is elbow extension. Antagonist of which is biceps. So biceps ne contract karwana, that is, you try to contract as much as possible and then ask the patient to relax. When the patient relaxes, you go for stretching of biceps. This I have done very slowly, you will have to do it very fast. That is, first contract, 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 full range of motion, contract, 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 and then later on, ask the patient to relax. Same patient relax, correct? Go for extension. Yes, so in addition to say, elbow extension, range of motion improved. So, whenever you are going for contract and relax, direct method, this is termed as direct method, direct sukam. એન્ટાગોનિસ્ટ છે જેના લીધે રેન્જ રેસ્ટ્રિક્ટેડ છે અને ડિરેક્ટલી આપણે ટ્રીટ કરીએ છીએ. નાઉ ધ પેશન્ટ કમ્પ્લેન્સ કે ના ધ પેશન્ટ સેઝ ધે હેવ પેઇન વ્હાઇલ યુ આર પરફોર્મિંગ ધ મોશન. સો વોટ ઓપ્શન અધર ઓપ્શન વી હેવ ટુ ટ્રીટ ધ ઓર કોન્ટ્રેક્ટ ધ એગોનિસ્ટ. એગોનિસ્ટ ને કોન્ટ્રેક્ટ કરીએ ફોર અવર કેસ ઇટ વિલ બી ટ્રાઇસેપ્સ મસલ. યસ. So what we will do, we will ask the patient to contract, 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 contract as much as possible, resisted motion, and then when the patient relaxes, go for extension. Yes. So that is termed as indirect method. Why? Because jene problem che, any treatment nahi karta hai na, opposite muscle na treatment kari che. But our two important terms that we have learned already, autogenic inhibition and reciprocal innervation, both come into play. Autogenic, કઈ રીતે direct method માં biceps ને contract કરી છે, contract, 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 following a forceful contraction, the muscle has to relax. Contraction પછી relax થવું જ જોઈએ. તો patient relax કરશે, muscle relax થશે, એ time આપણે stretch કરીને range વધારી દઈએ છીએ. So this is the principle of autogenic inhibition applied in direct method. Another, for indirect method, when we are going for agonist contraction, the problem biceps માં છે પણ એમાં pain એટલું થાય છે કે આપણે એને treat નથી કરી શકતા, patient ને treat નથી કરી શકતા, તો directly we will lead to contraction of triceps indirectly. Yes, triceps contract કરે તો biceps ને relax થવું પડે. Rule of reciprocal innervation. And when reciprocal innervation is working, the biceps has to relax. Biceps relax in you and then you are again going for elbow extension. So that will again improve the range of motion. Same principle, contract and relax and hold and relax. Sorry, both principles of contract and relax, autogenic inhibition and reciprocal innervation, will be applied same in hold and relax also. What is the difference between contract and relax, hold and relax? We are going to discuss further. So, characterization, resisted isotonic contraction of the restrictive muscle, antagonist followed by movement into resisted, the increased range of motion. Always the motion that is restricted, antagonist relaxed, how to motion antibody selection method to contracted reaction in the motion restriction. So we are directly treating the antagonist by movement into the increased range of motion. So here two important terms come. First is antagonist and second is isotonic. We go for specifically concentric contraction and the type of exercise will be resisted exercise. Yes, we go for resisted motion. Contract kar also muscle hai, and then when the patient asks the patient to relax, when they are relaxing, we go for increasing the range of motion. The therapist moves the joint to an end of the passive range of motion. Active motion or motion against little resistance is preferred. Always we prefer the resisted motion. Now, if the patient is not able to take resistance, patient is weak functioning, patient is weak, plus there is limited range of motion, at that time you may even allow active range of motion as much as possible and then go for relaxation. The therapist asks the patient for the stronger contraction of the restricting muscles or patterns, and contraction should be held for at least 5 to 8 seconds. Reflecting full range of motion from complete elbow extension or the available range chain and the complete flexion to the 5 to 8 seconds ma complete ho jo contraction 5 to 8 seconds rakhwan che, then ask the patient to relax. Yes, 8 second 2 second ma contract karne relax nahi karon, then it will not work. Our rules of autogenic inhibition does not work that way. We need to keep the contraction at least for 5 to 8 seconds, then only we ask the patient to relax and we can move the part into increased range of motion. The therapist tells the patient to relax. Pehla contract kar liyo, 5 to 8 seconds ma contraction complete kar liyo, pachi we'll ask the patient to relax. The joint or the body part is repositioned either actively or passively to the new limit of range of motion. Most of the time it will be passively. After passively, elbow extend torso and will increase the range of motion. The technique is repeated until no more range is gained. But utmost important to understand, no more range is gained in that sitting. Yes. So with this contract and relax and hold and relax or PNS stretching as a whole, you can gain up to 5 to 10 degrees in one sitting approx. Will derive on pathology. Sena lihe restricted che in a perpan depend kar se. Yes, it is not ke ek varma 10 degree aavu jo joye. Yes, if the pathology is chronic, anamila ta samay thi che because of any reason, then the range will be limited to even less than 5 degree. Yes, it is not sure ke to how se. But you can overall, average you can consider 5 to 10 degrees can be achieved in one sitting through stretching, that is PNS stretching, contract and relax and hold and relax also. Contract and relax indicate indirect method. So indirect, as we talked about, indirect so come use karsu ke jare biceps je restrict kare che elbow extension is painful. Bahu j pain thai che patient while they are trying to do the contraction of biceps muscle. Then only we go for indirect method, otherwise we always go for direct method. Je muscle restrict kare che ene treat karvanu. જે મસલ રેસ્ટ્રિક્ટ કરે છે અને એને કોઈ બીજી પેથોલોજી ના લીધે પેઇન પણ થાય છે તો એને ટ્રીટ ના કરીને ઓપોઝિટ એટલે એગોનિસ્ટ મસલ ને ટ્રીટ કરવાનું. ધ ટેકનિક યુઝિસ કોન્ટ્રેક્શન ઓફ ધ એગોનિસ્ટ મસલ ઇન્સ્ટેડ ઓફ ધ શોર્ટનડ મસલ. યસ, એગોનિસ્ટ ઇન અવર કેસ ઇટ ઇઝ ટ્રાઇસેપ્સ મસલ. યુઝ ધ ઇનડાયરેક્ટ મેથડ વેન ધ કોન્ટ્રેક્શન ઓફ રેસ્ટ્રિક્ટિંગ મસલ ઇઝ ટુ પેઇનફુલ ઓર ટુ વીક ટુ પ્રોડ્યુસ એન ઇફેક્ટિવ કોન્ટ્રેક્શન. Effective contraction patient can't carry the patient and bahut dukhao thai che or contraction is so weak or the patient's muscles are weak and decreased range of motion, bahut weak hoy and restricted range of motion ase, at that time it is advisable that we only go for indirect method, that is treat the agonist instead of antagonist. So this is about contract and relax. Same thing, only one difference that we are going to observe for hold and relax. So hold and relax will have only one change, the type of contraction. There we were talking about isotonic or concentric, and in that we are providing full active resisted range of motion. That was about contract and relax. Have you seen our hold and relax? Hold, as the name suggests, is to stop, yes, or maintain. Hold your position, yes. So be where you are, or do not try to move. So that is what is hold and relax. So it will be isometric type of contraction in which the length of the muscle will not change. So there is no motion intended. Patient motion nahi kar sake. Range of motion plus minus nahi karwa. Patient actively nahi kare. Aise bhi aap kar sakte. Yes. In contract and relax, we were doing resisted range of motion exercises. Here also resistance is provided, but the resistance of was higher intensity. By higher intensity, we do not want the patient to do any movement. So say for example, biceps restricting, elbow extension, so full extension nahi thatu. So shu karvanu? Contract and relax ma, we will talk first of direct method. Yes, so contract and relax ma, we are contracting the biceps muscle and then asking the patient to relax. Jem patient relax kare, we move the part into extension and increase the range of motion. In hold and relax, start ahiya thi karvanu, same thing, khali contraction nahi thava devanu. That is, we try to maintain this into isometric contraction. You do resistance apvanu or ask the patient to match your resistance as much as possible and then ask the patient to relax. Again, ask the patient to relax. When the patient is relaxing, you go for increasing the range of motion. Only difference type of contraction. Ek ma movement hai che, contract and relax movement se, hold and relax movement nahi hai. That is the only difference.
So, resisted isometric contraction of the muscles, antagonist muscle, here also, direct and indirect to outset. Yes, directly it like antagonist ne treat karo, indirectly it like agonist ne treat karo. So first is agonistic muscle, which is the shortened muscle, followed by relaxation. When the patient is relaxing, at that time you improve the range of motion, increase the range of motion passively through stretching. First, to increase the passive range of motion and to decrease pain also, this is helpful because there is no motion involved. We can't मूवमेंट આપણે કરતા નથી તો એના માટે પણ પેઇન ની વધારે ડિક્રીઝ કરી શકે. ઇન્ડિકેશન ડિક્રીઝ પેસિવ રેન્જ ઓફ મોશન એન્ડ પેઇન. સો અગેન ફ્રોમ ધેટ ઓન ધી ઇન્ક્રીઝ પેસિવ રેન્જ ઓફ મોશન, સો વેન ધ ડિક્રીઝ પેસિવ રેન્જ ઓફ મોશન વી વિલ પ્રોવાઇડ. સો ઓલસો ગોલ ટુ ડિક્રીઝ ધ પેઇન. સો વેન ધેર ઇઝ પેઇન ધેન ઓન્લી યુ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ અપ્લાય ધીસ ટેકનિક. કોન્ટ્રા ઇન્ડિકેશન, પેશન્ટ ઇઝ અનેબલ ટુ આઇસોમેટ્રિક કોન્ટ્રેક્શન. નાઉ વેનેવર આઈ આસ્ક યુ ટુ પરફોર્મ આઇસોમેટ્રિક કોન્ટ્રેક્શન ઓફ એની મસલ ઓફ એની જોઈન્ટ, you will be thinking first of all what is the action, and then you know the anatomy, you know the physiology, and that is why you will be able to do it more effectively. But instructing a patient, instructing a layman or a person who does not understand medical terminologies or has not experienced what is physiotherapy before, they will not be able to effectively or efficiently do isometric contraction. You ask the patient to do elbow flexion. Now say for example, the patient is a guy who goes to gym every day and works out specifically for his upper body, and you ask him to do biceps isometric contraction, he will lift you yourself up. Yes, that will be his strength. So to make someone understand what is isometric contraction is difficult, it's not that easy. Yes, so when the patient is not able to understand what is isometric contraction, do not use this technique. Then it is useless to go with this technique. Instead, use the contract and relax method. For increasing range of motion, description is, so for increasing the range of motion, patient moves the joint to the end of the passive range of motion. Resistance may be given. If active motion is very painful, the therapist moves to the joint passively. The therapist asks for isometric contraction again, 5 to 8 seconds rule here also applies. Yes, so if the patient is doing 5 to 8 seconds, then only the rule of autogenic inhibition will come into play, and after that, following a forceful contraction, the muscle will relax. When the muscle is relaxing, you go for increasing the range of motion by passive stretching. Contraction maintained for 5 to 8 seconds. Therapist asks the patients to relax. Joint is repositioned either actively or passively to the new limit of range of motion. For decreasing the pain, patient is in the position of comfort. The therapist resists an isometric contraction of muscle affecting the painful segment. So whichever part is painful, just for the painful purpose, we can also give. So position the patient as such, where the patient does not have enough or patient is most of the time relieved. So that is also termed as position of comfort or POC. We are also going to see one of the techniques, special techniques, when we are going to discuss about the last portion of your exercise therapy code itself. And the therapist resists an isometric contraction, so same, we will provide an isometric contraction of muscles affecting the painful segment. Say for example, there is pain in the biceps muscle, so you will provide the contraction and ask the patient to relax. Here the intention is not here the intention is not to increase the range of motion, here the intention is to relieve the pain. So pain relief around is super, so resistance also, and when the patient is relaxing, move the part passively slowly into the again starting position, or where it is just maintain it. As it is holding leg, there will be no contraction. In the indirect treatment, indirect, at least agonist treat curriculum. In our case, it was triceps, in our example. You resist the synergies of the shortened or painful muscle and not the painful muscle. If that still causes pain, resist the synergistic muscle of the opposite vector. Now, synergist or synergic muscles, a new term, yes, something that you might have learned before. So, something known as prime mover, which is also termed as agonist and antagonist. Synergists are those muscles which help the prime movers achieve the range of motion. Let's say, for example, in our case, corrective brachialis or radiobrachialis. They will be the muscles that will be helping the biceps brachii muscle for contraction of elbow. Yes. So brachioradialis and corticobrachialis that will help the biceps muscle for contraction, and that are termed as synergistic muscle. So biceps muscle painful, so corticobrachialis or brachioradialis, both can be given resistance, but if that is also painful, then we should go to antagonist. At the pillars of the tricuspid prime mover. Prime mover na linkage restriction hai se, but prime mover painful contraction se, prime mover no contraction curve is too much painful for the patient. So even isometric, we are not talking about contract and less, we are talking about hold and less, only isometric contraction also. Yes, and in that indirect, we can go for brachioradialis, that is the arm in the mid prone and completely prone position for brachioradialis. So that also, if it is painful, then we go for extension, that is triceps itself, agonist. Indication that the contraction of restricting muscle is too painful, then only we go for such motion. The patient in the position of comfort, therapist resists the isometric contraction of synergistic muscle distant from the painful segment, and the resistance is built up slowly and remains at the level below that which causes pain. During relaxation, the resistance decreases slowly. After we have discussed both these methods of contract and relax, hold and relax, I'll also show you one example of how direct and indirect methods can be useful for both contract and relax and hold and relax in patterns specifically. Yes. We are already, as I have already told you in before lectures, that most of the time we are using hold and relax, contract and relax in orthopedic condition, but we might also use it for increasing strength, force of contraction for muscles, or to decrease the pain also. So say, for example, we are treating the patient and the patient is complaining for wrist flexion pain. Yes, so when the patient is doing wrist flexion, it is painful. So for that, what will I provide? I will provide hold and relax, more of it. Why? Because movement is painful. Movement is painful. If like a resisted movement, it's going to be painful. Better to go for isometric contraction, so using the hold and relax. So elbow flexion is painful. So which muscles will be restricting? Antagonist. Yes. So elbow extensors need to be given resistance, isometric resistance. So patient will be sitting position on a chair or with the head on the edge, wrist outside the edge of the table, and then you are going to provide extension as much as possible. Resist the extension, ask the patient to match the resistance, and the patient will look very simple. Just within 5 to 8 seconds, we are going to hold, and then when the patient, ask the patient to relax. If it is 8 seconds, ask the patient to relax, and then you move the part or maintain the position again. So this forceful contraction will lead to directly autogenic inhibition of the same muscle. That is how you will relieve the pain. Also, if it is way too painful, then you go for indirect method. Indirect method, you are going to treat the wrist flexor. So wrist flexion neutral position or the end position, whatever it is, you ask the patient to contract within this time through the principle of reciprocal inhibition. The opposite muscle group has to relax, and when it is relaxing, automatically the pain will reduce. Yes. So that is hold and relax and contract and relax, two important methods you are going to use very frequently in clinical postings. Yes. And for the last, we'll keep it for the next lecture, that is replication. Okay, I guess we can continue. We have enough time. Yes, so replication, as the name suggests, what we do in exams to copy, that is replicate, xerox, yes, that is also replication. So replication is a technique to facilitate motor learning of functional activities. Now say for example, I don't know how to sit on a chair, or I don't know how to stand from a chair. Yes, we'll consider an example of I don't know standing from the chair. So the patient will be in sitting position. Now he or she does not know how to stand, so the patient has to learn. This process is termed as motor learning. Yes, how to learn? To learn karva mate there are two ways. Ideally you should, what you should do, you should ask the patient to train their upper limb, train their lower limb, train their trunk muscles, strengthening karavo, resisted exercise aapko, and then slowly and steadily you ask them what the movements are and you go for teaching the whole process. But here in PNF we are doing the complete opposite. Yes, aapne sun kar chu patient ne sita uba karine chu passively, we ask them to maintain this position. Yes, next thing, we ask the patient to move slowly back to the starting position. એટલે કે આવા પ્રોસેસમાં સ્ટેપ્સ કેટલા છે? This I did almost many steps in between. So I can stop here, I can stop here, I can stop here, I can stop here, I can stop here. Yes, so if we consider 5 steps, so after 5 steps, for example. So from standing, you ask the patient to bend a bit and move to the starting position, hold. અહીંયા પછી હોલ્ડ કરવાનું થઈ ગયું. Yes, again move to the starting position, that is the ending position. Starting position, ending position માં confuse નહીં થવાનું. Ideally, I want to teach, this is the starting position, patient બેઠા હોય. And what is something that I want the patient to do? I want him to stand, so that is the ending position. But replication માં opposite છે. Our starting position in replication is ending position of the treatment that we are providing. Yes? એટલે કે મારે ટ્રીટમેન્ટ ક્યાંથી સ્ટાર્ટ કરવાની છે, મારે ઓલરેડી એને શીખવાડવું છે. યસ, ઇફ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ટીચ હિમ ટુ ટેક ધીસ ફ્રોમ ધી એર વિથ માય લેફ્ટ હેન્ડ ઇઝ નોટ એબલ ટુ ડુ ઇટ, આઈ વિલ આસ્ક હિમ ટુ ડુ ધીસ ફર્સ્ટ. ધીસ ઇઝ માય સ્ટાર્ટિંગ પોઝિશન. યસ, ઓપોઝિટ. ફ્રોમ હિયર આઈ આસ્ક હિમ ટુ મૂવ સ્લાઇટલી બેક ઇનટુ ધ પ્રોસેસ, જે પણ સ્ટેપ્સ હતા એના આગલા સ્ટેપ પર જવાનું, હોલ્ડ, અગેન કમ બેક, અગેન હોલ્ડ, કમ બેક. નાવ ઇમ્પ્રુવ, યસ, ઇન્ક્રીઝ ટુ ધ સ્ટેપ 2, ધેટ ઇઝ Yes, so this is step 2. Now come to the starting position. Step 2, come to starting position. Step 3, this is the step 3, almost sitting down, and come back. Hold this position, come back. Step 3, hold this position, come back. Step 4, already applied 5 and 4 multiply. Ask the patient to sit, maintain, and stand. Ask the patient to sit, maintain, and stand. And step 5, completely relax, sit and relax. Yes, so completely sit and relax, and then come back to the normal position. So apne chalu end position thi karyu ane nahi aaya starting position. So that is what is the replication. So teach the patient the end position of the movement. Je pan tamare teach karyu chhe, je pan tamare sikhavu chhe, I want you to excel in the exams. Yes, exams માં 100% લઈ આવવાના છે. તમને process નહીં કહો, તમે સીધો report card આપી દો. Then you want to do the process. That is application. Fourth semester માં you will all get, or third semester માં you will all get 100%. તમને સીધો result આપી દો. Yes, and now you have to work accordingly. Yes, so that is termed as application. So teach the patient the end position of the movement. Assess the patient's ability to sustain a contraction while the agonist muscles are shortened. So when the, whenever you are asking the patient a end position ma avo, to pehla to patient ne position hold karvani chahiye, just standing patient ne hold karvani, then you go for shortened position. Yes, એન્ડ પોઝિશન જે આપણી સ્ટાર્ટિંગ પોઝિશન છે ત્યાંથી સ્લોલી એન્ડ સ્ટેડીલી જોવાનું પેશન્ટ કોન્ટ્રેક્શન કેટલું મેન્ટેન કરી શકે છે. ધ પેશન્ટ ઇઝ નોટ એબલ ટુ મેન્ટેન, યુઝ અધર ટેકનિક્સ ઓફ પીએનએફ. ઇફ મિસ મસલ્સ માં સ્ટ્રેન્થ છે તો જ યુ યુઝ રેપ્લિકેશન, અધરવાઇઝ યુ ડોન્ટ યુઝ રેપ્લિકેશન. યસ, ધેટ ઇઝ ધ મોસ્ટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ મોડ ફોર રેપ્લિકેશન. Place the patient in the end position of the activity where all agonist muscles are shortened. Yes, જે પણ agonist muscles are standing માં જે પણ muscles act કરવા જોઈએ બધા એના shortened position માં છે. Then the patient holds that position while the therapist raises all the components as the patient to relax. એટલે કે પહેલા ઊભો રહેવાનું છે, then slowly and steadily we start challenging the patient. We can do it passively through resistance or change the position from starting position to ending position. Ask the patient to relax, move the patient passively in a short duration distance back on the opposite direction and ask the patient to return to the end position. એટલે કે passively we can move the patient into shortened position, then ask the patient to come back. Again move the patient in shortened position, ask the patient to come back, and slowly and steadily we improve the range of motion and ask the patient to completely sit and stand. This is it. 7 techniques specific to PNF. Specific to neurological and even to some extent orthopedic conditions. With this, we are completing the PNF topic as a whole. The main books that I have referred and you will find the PNF in is Adler, and even the same book that we discussed, Margaret Hollis has given Practical Exercise Therapy and PNF in Practice. If you want to read the books, they are very large books. If you want to still, I'll provide the link and provide the book itself, soft copy in the group itself. Yes, it will take a lot of time. You can refer the PPT for the reference also. Yes, so any doubts in the whole PNF that we have discussed so far, please write in the chat.